In the world of application performance, you hear us talk a lot about the 60 frames per second and 16 millisecond barriers. But have you ever stopped to ask why those numbers are relevant? My name is Colt McAnlis, and if you're a developer who's serious about performance, this is the type of technical minutia that's worth knowing. Now let's take a step back and understand that most of this has to do with hardware, human hardware. See, the human eye doesn't act like a camera. There's no snapshot of the world that gets sent over the brain to make sure that you don't run into that new piece of furniture in your living room. Instead, the brain is continuously processing visual signals that the eye is sending to it. There's no concept of frame or snapshots in this regard. Our concept of motion that comes from still frames is effectively a hack. See, by displaying images fast enough, we can trick the human brain into perceiving motion where there actually isn't any. The caveat here is that how fast we display those images has a large effect on how fluid the motion will actually look to us. See, at a minimum, you need about 10 to 12 frames per second before the human brain starts to perceive motion from a flipbook. However, it doesn't actually look that smooth. 24 frames per second allows the human eye to see fluid motion, but that's only thanks to visual effects like motion blurring. And by the way, 24 frames per second is a sweet spot for the film industry, since it's fast enough to show motion, but cheap enough to produce for films on a budget, which is why for the past 50 years, most of the movies you see are displaying at 24 frames per second. Now, 30 frames per second is enough for movies, but without the fancy cinematic effects, it's actually not that convincing. While 60 frames per second is actually the sweet spot. Great, smooth motion without all the tricks, and most humans can't perceive the benefits of going higher than this number. Now, it's worth noting that the human eye is very discerning when it comes to inconsistencies in these frame rates. For example, if you're moving along at 60 frames per second and then you suddenly drop to 20 frames per second every now and again, the human eye will see this lack of smoothness. This tends to cause lots of tension and uneasiness for your users. As an app developer, your goal is clear. Keep your app at 60 frames per second and then keep it there through the duration of the user's experience with it. Now, what 60 frames per second means for you as a developer is that you've got 16 milliseconds per frame to do all of your work. That is, input, computing, network, and rendering every frame to stay fluid for your users. You can't argue with this. The math says so. And there's an entire boatload of issues that can cause your frame to take longer than 16 milliseconds. To find those problems and fix them right, make sure you check out the rest of the Android Performance Patterns content. And don't forget to join our Google Plus community as well. So keep calm, profile your code, and always remember, perf matters.